Saints projects. So I'm going to show you first. We are not starting the keynote at all. That was a really hard thing for some people to grasp last class. We are not starting the keynote yet. We're just doing research today, and I know that that is disappointing for some of you who love keynotes, but I promise we're going to start it next week. We've got to get the research part done first. So I'm going to show you first. Mrs. Gardner changed this project a little bit for you guys this year, so I made a new keynote reflecting the changes. Please find the rubric that's on your table that looks like this. I know Mrs. Gardner gave you a separate rubric, but mine's a little different than hers. Mine has like what you need for the slides. So this is how you're going to order your slides. It's very close to hers. They match almost exactly, but I just have it broken down in the slides. Let's see, what am I doing? Okay, so I made this one for you guys. Just, I think it's a good idea to look at this before you start your research. So if you look at your paper, this is slide one. It just includes your saint's name and your name. So there's not much research there. You should have that already. Slide two, all you need is the date and year they were born. But a lot of kids found in the last class that they could not find the date. So if your person was born a really long time ago, you might not be able to find the exact day, like March 12th, and that's fine. Just put the year down. That'll do. Okay? If you can find the date, then definitely write that down. But if you cannot, don't sweat. Alright? Then find the place she lived. A few people in the last class could only find the country, not the town. That's a little, most people found the town. But if you can't, the country will do as well. And then when they die. So those are the three facts you need. And when you do your research today, you're going to just write to the side on my paper the date and year they were born. You're going to write it down neatly so you can read it next week. I walked around and a few people, I just asked them, are you going to be able to read this next week? Because I can't read their handwriting. So hopefully you guys can read your own handwriting. Then you're going to write down the town. You're just going to write it beside it. Okay, also have a notebook paper if you'd like one. Okay, slide three is religious life. So you need their feast day. Here's her feast day, April 11th. Her symbol is the stigmata. And what they're the patron of. She's the patron saint of pharmacists. Okay? So those are the three facts you need to find for this. Guys, I'm not answering questions right now. You can just listen. I'll take questions in a minute. Next slide. Five interesting facts. Okay, so these are her five interesting facts about her saint. Mrs. Gardner wanted me to make sure you guys knew that it should be interesting facts, not just a fact like she liked to take long walks. That's not so interesting. Try to find the most interesting things you can. Like she saw a guardian angel. That's pretty interesting. She had stigmata. That's very interesting. Anything like that would be good. Okay? Some people in the last class finished all four of these slides, slides one, two, three, and four. Well, the research that is, not actually creating the slides, we're not doing the keynote. So slide five is gonna be your own writing. So we're not gonna do that part today. You're gonna write this some other time after you've done your research and you've learned from your saint. So you're not gonna do this today, but this is what it's gonna look like. Your own writing of what you learned from your saint. Okay? And then the next slide is a quote. That's slide six. A famous quote from your saint. One, and you're going to find that. You're going to go to Google and find the saint. Or you might find it in a book, or you might find it in your research today. So a few people got to that in the last class. So when they finished researching slides two, three, and four, I said, okay, we'll go ahead and find your saint quote. So you'll just go to Google and look up quote by Saint Jude or Saint Paul. And then you'll be able to find a nice quote and write it down on your paper. Okay? And then slide seven is your prayer that you're going to write. And you're not going to do that today. You're going to do that in class with Mrs. Gardner. And you'll bring that back with you when you have it. Okay? So that's what we're doing today. table. And then we're also going to be using a website that I started to show you last week when you were in here. It is in the ACS folder. And then Catholic Sites. And then Catholic Online. And when you get in Catholic Online, on the left-hand side, look for Saints and Angels. So when you get to Saints and Angels, then you'll be given this box where you will search for your saints. So if I'm going to do St. George like I did last week, type it in and search. Now usually you're going to see these in red on the side. These are ads. See, it says add, 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 add. So if you brought your credit card with you to class today, you can go ahead and do some shopping. Okay? I'm just joking. You guys are all looking at me like, Amelia's the only one who's left. So, not really. Just pass these until you get to the first entry right here. Okay? So here's my St. George Saints, Saints and Angels. Now, some of them, there's many saints with that name. I have two St. Georges. This is not the one I'm looking for. This is the most popular St. George. So if you're not sure which one she assigned you, raise your hand and I'll help you figure out which one you're supposed to be looking at. Okay? Because there are, like even St. Francis, there's a couple of different St. Francis's, but the most popular St. Francis is St. Francis of Assisi. Okay, so I'm going to click on St. George, and if you look at this, this is what we looked at last week. Right away, you can see, okay, feast day, I need that. Patron, I need that. Death, I need that. It only has the year of his death, not the exact day, and that's fine. Okay, then we're going to scroll down. Now, this Catholic Online can be a little difficult to read. It's a little bit, maybe a higher level reading than some of you are on. But you can figure out some of it. Like we read through this last week when we were talking about paraphrasing. This is his death date. And then, you know, you can find out a few other information maybe in this. Also, you can watch the video, okay? So we can use the headphones today, but please do not put the headphones back because they need to be cleaned before they go back. Those were all cleaned after the last class, so they're clean for you. So please don't get them and then go put them back because then they won't be sterile anymore, okay? So you can watch this video. And this video, oh, please don't lose your focus. This video really is exactly what this says, which is nice because it helps if it's hard to read some of this, okay? So this is going to have some good information for you. Like here's the story with George and the dragons, which is a very popular story. That would be a great interesting fact, wouldn't it? That George slew a dragon, or that's the legend anyway, okay? So then, oh, look, look, I scrolled all the way down and I came to a heading that said interesting fact. Well, that's convenient because I need five interesting facts. Wow. There's way more than five interesting facts here. Cool. So I can read through those and pick which ones are most interesting. Okay? So you have that. And if you finish all of those first four slides, like I said, you can go to Google and type in quote by Saint. Enter and then see what quotes you can find. Okay, look through here. This should be a good one. Happy St. George's Day quotes. If you need help with this, let me know and maybe we can find a good quote together. Another good thing to do is just go to images, and oftentimes you'll see a quote by St. George just on an image, like this. You might have to look through a few of them to find. But if you need help with that, just let me know and I can help you find a good quote. But most saints have a lot of quotes. Like, you'll probably have to pick one from a bunch of different saints. Okay? Any questions? Okay, so I have a few students in the last class who didn't write down any facts. They were just reading the articles. And then I said, well, where are your facts? Oh, I'm supposed to be writing them down? Yes. Unless you think you can remember it for next week, which I know I couldn't remember all those facts for next week. So make sure you write them down. This is your grade for today, doing the research. If you need notebook paper, I prefer to write on lined paper. You're welcome to take a piece of this
and you can staple it to your paper.
Okay. So the first thing we're all going to do right now is write our names on this that I gave you. Okay, everyone do that right now. And then you can go ahead and get started, and I will come around and answer any questions that you may have. Okay? Books back here, you can just, it's just, you know, first come, first serve. Yes. Obvious, and it might be hard to find.